Could I say something?
Dad is dead. That's all there is.
How can you be so sure?
I am, okay?
No. Tell me. Tell me, how can you be so sure?
I'm sorry I even brought you here. I thought you were different.
What do you mean different?
No, never mind.
No. Tell me. I'm all ears.
All ears, huh?
Yeah, see? All ears.
I saw a couple of them with sets of keys. Here comes another set right now.
Hi, everyone. Game's getting pretty intense already, right?
Why are you doing this?
Why are you doing this?
You're fucking crazy.
You know, you agreed to be here. You're basically asking my family for a handout. The least you could do, pig. You show a little fucking respect.
Psycho little bitch.
Excuse me?
You heard me. Bitch.
I'm sorry, we didn't get formally introduced.
Well, now we have. How about you show us a little respect,
Stop.
Huh?
Stop. What's your name? Pig, what's your name?
Travis Schultz.
Okay, Travis. You're the soldier, right? Well, allow me to thank you for your bravery and your service. Really. But, yeah, that said, opening your mouth was a big mistake.
Easy.
So. Cover the walls and the area around the table. That's police brutality.
Oh. Police brutality is what's going to happen to you next if you don't apologize to the lady.
Sorry.
Go ahead, detective.
So, Sammy. Yesterday afternoon, security guards at JFK Middle School saw you chase a 10-year-old boy named Tristan onto school grounds, threatening to rip his head off.
A hypothetical situation. You walk into your apartment, you find some kid who's ripping you off. He jumps out the window, runs away. Do you A, sit down, knit him a pair of socks, or do you B, kick his ass?
A 10-year-old kid stole from a big bad D-bag like you?
Yeah, he took my Surface tablet and a couple $100 in cash.
So after you got chased off by school security, did you A, follow Tristan home, and B, show up this morning to shoot his mother in the chest?
I'm gonna pop some kid's mom for a tablet and a couple $100. What kind of person do I look like?
A douchebag.
Now I'm offended.
Hey, what's he doing here?
I don't know.
Here. Don't smoke it all in one place. Thanks. Yeah. Man, you gotta clean up around here every once in a while, dude.
No, I told Jason already. Got another deal today.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. This works out, I'm a made man. Get you in on it if you like.
What's the deal?
Well, you know Carl, right? He's got this big fish in tow. Some hotshot West Coaster. I'm going in for 5,000.
Crazy Carl? You're about to do business with that psycho. You got it all together?
No, not all of it. Still have to do more work today. Could you, like, give me a little loan?
I don't know, man. I'm really kind of broke right now. I could give you, like, a 20 if you want.
Oh, anything. Oh, I gotta get out of here. I'm so fucking sick of this place. I'm gonna buy me an island, and then... Oh, So what about Valerie?
Maybe we don't belong with each other.
She's too good for you anyway. White trash.
That's cold.
Feeling better? I made tea. I'm afraid you had, well, a little too much to drink. Mr. Maroney, he has a strange sense of humor.
Oswald, I am not some bumpkin from the country with hay in my brains. I am your mother, and I will love you no matter what. Lie to me now. You will break my heart. Oswald, have you done things you should not?
Mother, I'm a nightclub owner. That's all.
I can bring tears to your eyes and resurrect the dead. I form in an instant and last a lifetime. What am I?
Memory. So what?
You were humming this under your covers. I figure it has meaning for you.
Every night when I was young, my mother would sing that song to me when I was going to bed. And every time, she would tell me, Oswald. Don't listen to the other children. You're handsome and clever. And someday you will be a great man. She said that every time. That's all I have left now. Memories. And they're like daggers in my heart.
Not forever. These were Miss Kringle's. It's all I have left to remember her by. But when I look at these, I don't feel sadness anymore. I feel gratitude. And do you know why?
No. And I don't care. This little visit is over.
Give up, Nigma. Save your own ass. Live to love another day. Hey?
Wow.
What's going on? You have a weird look on your face. Like, weirder than normal.
You're right. I should want him dead.
Should? Oswald. You loved him. And he betrayed you.
Actually, I don't know that I did. Love him. Not really.
What?
Ed was right. I thought I loved him because he saw me as no one had since my mother. But I killed Isabel.
I'm pretty sure her name is Isabella, but go on.
I wouldn't share him. Ed said love is sacrifice. I should have been able to sacrifice my happiness for his. I couldn't. But I'm ready now. I won't call Ed. I won't let you hurt him.
So you'd rather die than give up the man who tried to kill you?
I would. Isn't that crazy?
Yes. It is.
Guess you're not as smart as you thought you were. He didn't give you up after all.
You're in this together. But why?
Because I didn't want to just take what you had. I wanted to take what you believed. I wanted you to die, knowing that you were incapable of loving another person.
But I can't. I just proved that, right? Does that mean I passed? Ed?
I don't know what it means. Don't you get tired of making the same mistake over and over?
You think I'm making a mistake?
Well, instead of killing me when you had the chance, you've decided to feed your ego.
You want to talk ego, Riddler?
You will always fail, Oswald, because you will always let your base emotions drive you. Hate, anger, fear, love.
Shut up.
You want to know why I could never love someone like you, Oswald?
I'm warning you.
Because you are a spoiled child who throws a tantrum anytime he doesn't get what he wants. Especially when what he wants doesn't want him back.
You're right. I shouldn't have waited. But unlike you, I am in the position to rectify my mistake. Prepare for one massive tantrum. No! That is not possible! It is my turn! It is my turn to kill you!
Like I said, you will always fail because you'll never change.
Maybe, but at least I know who I am. That day by the edge of the river, that was the moment you were reborn. And that was a lie! Your entire persona is based on a lie. And there is nothing you can do to change that.
At 10:35, 20 minutes after shooting the president, Booth arrives at the Navy Yard Bridge, his escape route into Maryland. Sergeant Silas T. Cobb of the 13th Regiment Massachusetts Heavy Artillery is on sentry duty.
Halt, who goes?
Friend.
Name?
My name is Booth.
Where from?
I'm from the city.
Where are you headed?
Down home, Charles County.
What town?
I don't live in a town. I live near Beantown.
I don't know where that place is, friend, but do you know it's against the law to cross here after 9 o'clock? What is your object to be in town so late when you got so far to travel?
It is a dark road. I thought if I waited till now, I should have the light of this moon to help me see my way.
Well, I will let you pass. But I don't know as I ought to.
Hell. There'll be no trouble about that.